comes in the investing team that went to China for the World University Games. Even though I was in Zimbabwe, it was a nice experience. And so I coached in table tennis, licensed to coach, and then I coached in soccer, very licensed to C and licensed to B. But when I met my education, I had to put all of those things on the side, that I saw my education to be on top. I joined pretty young, like in the third year. So I hope that by the time we are through with my lecture, we'll be able to connect in our hearts. And possibly, hopefully, there'll be a change in mind. So I'm so happy to be here, and thank you very much for having me. I'll start with a short story. Two boys, John and Jerry, find themselves at a village with a tall wall. So when they got there, John and Jerry met the sound, 13, 13, 13. So John wanted to know what was happening. And Jerry told John that they shouldn't bother, they should move on. But John insisted and he found a small hole. So when he tried to look in the hole to see what was happening behind the wall, then the number changed from 13 to 14, 14, 14, and guess what? John lost his eyes. So apparently those behind the wall were just, you know, piercing themselves into the eyes of anyone who tried to look in the hole. If John had listened to Jerry, probably he would lose his sight. That brings us to listening. I'm going to talk about listening today. On average, it takes 3 years for a child to speak, and it takes about 30 years for a trait to change, but it takes 60 years to listen. So you can imagine, children by age 3, they should be talking. And if you have a trait and it's only 10, you're going to process, taking research shows that it takes about 30 years for that to change, and it takes you 60 years to listen. That is why our grandfathers and grandmothers take time to listen to us. But by the time they are through with life, even if they don't want to, they shall have a hold of them, so they have no choice than to listen. That's why averagely takes 60 years to listen. But of course, you can do better than getting to 60 before you listen. A question for us. What then is listening? Can we have a guess? Can anybody help? What is listening? These are teachers. You are, I'm like you, we are all together, so I hope that you will connect with us. Anybody to share a view on listening? Anybody? Yes?
To pay attention to something.
Well, let's put our hands together. Yes. Can you just say it now?
The ability to receive information from the other.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Great. You know, it's easy when you have a teacher because they're always reading and it makes my work easy. Actually, the answers you gave were right. But let's consider the exam. Listening is an active process by which we make sense of, assess, and respond to what we hear. There is a difference between listening and hearing. I guess you know that. If your ear is able to perceive sound, then we say you are hearing. But you have to make meaning into what you have heard, then we say that you are listening. So that is a short definition to add up to what you already have, which of course is also true. Yeah. Now we have five stages of listening. And it's important that everyone goes through these stages and if possible gets to the highest stage. With the lowest, which is the ignoring stage, and then we have the pretended, we have the selective, we have the prudent, so attentive, and the highest form is the sympathetic or empathetic stage of listening. Each can be broken down into, let's say, touch. Listen, and I'm going to explain that really shortly. all of that is going to come against you. Don't worry about that. But, so the first one is ignoring. And as I said, that's the lowest four. And the second one is pretending. For those of you in here, the first time. And the third is selective listening. And the fourth, prudence listening. Then the sympathetic or the empathetic listening. There's a difference between sympathy and empathy. When we get there to explain, I guess, sorry. Let's take them one after the other. What does it mean to be the one who ignores? If you look at the scale, you see that the heart for the one who ignores is very high, and the knowledge base is low. We look on that. Those who ignore think they know. So there's no space for more info. So the knowledge they have actually is small. They can measure. But in their mind, they think they know, but their heart is just high. And they have little knowledge. They actually criticize a lot. People who ignore. They don't even look at you when you talk. You know, they just say, oh, therapy, that's not necessary. And because they would not listen to you, they will now criticize you after you've spoken. Because they did not get any depth of knowledge as what you were trying to communicate to them. So this is the lowest form of listening. And the next one is pretending. If you have questions, you write them down. After the lecture, I will answer them. The next stage is the pretending listener. And here also we have the heart of the one who pretends to listen to be high, and his knowledge, his or her knowledge is a little bit above that of the ignoring person, but it's also not much. You see that heart is high and knowledge. Pretenders also criticize a lot, and so if you like criticizing people without paying attention to what they say, then you have to check it, you know, as to where you fall. And like I said, they pretend to listen. Those who pretend to listen, and then their hearts are high and thoughts very low. And they do not love themselves, so they pretend a lot. If you love yourself, you will not be pretending. Because if you pretend to be dead, people will pretend and they will bury you. So if you love yourself, then you will be pretending. Then let's look at the third level of stage of title, which is the selective listener. And as usual, you see that for the selective listener, the heart is coming down a little, and the knowledge is also going up a little. So this one is much better than the first two we talked about earlier. And they, of course, also get criticized. And because they are selecting, they select who they want to listen to, and they select what they want to listen to. If it doesn't make sense to them, they will not listen. If, for instance, Apoto, I'm sure Apoto is here, right? Yes, if Apoto is talking and David doesn't want to listen to Apoto, then David will pick only what he wants to hear and leave the rest. So I've mentioned one of the staff at the seat more. So they select who they want to listen to, and they are self-centered. They just think about themselves. You know, others do not matter. Just them. And that's it. So they select, I don't think this is good for me. Well, this is okay. And that's about it. So they also miss out on a lot, because you don't get all that someone has to say to you. If you are selecting, that means your heart is already having something in there. Then they are strict about family members by generals to outsiders. At our homes, you know, some of our parents, when they come home, they are like lions in their house, they are strict, you know, but when you see them outside, it's a different story. You know, they are selective. They are so generous when you go out. But then at home, it's as if they are the king of the jungle. And if you do that a lot, that should tell you the level at which you are in terms of listening. Yeah. Then we want to look at the fourth type of listening, which is the attentive listener. Here, you are taking notes. And so that shows that you are attentive. But that's the, also called the prudence listener. Taking notes so you can grasp what you're trying to say. or what I'm trying to communicate. So you fall in this category at this moment, and then they take a note very well, accept, and they do not have great change in life because they listen halfway and then criticize halfway. Why can they criticize halfway? So when you look at the scale, they have come with some knowledge already, and because they have some, they cannot get 100% of what's the one who is talking about. Because you already have some in your heart, so if you need this one. So you cannot have great change in life if you are an attentive listener. Then let's look at the first form of listening. That's the empathetic or sympathetic listener. Then I talked about the difference. Is there anyone who can share with us the difference between being sympathetic and being empathetic? Anybody to share? It's actually a difference. I don't know, you want to try. Yes.
If you are sympathetic towards somebody, you feel for that person, you think you understand. But if you are empathetic, it means that you are putting yourself in the person's condition or the person's shoes, and you feel a lot more how the person feels than being sympathetic.
Wow, I couldn't agree with you more. Put your hands together for her. And that's so beautiful. So like you said, you can be sympathetic by saying, oh, I'm sorry you lost your mother, your father, you know. But if you're empathetic, you want to be with a person, you want to feel like he's feeling. You know, if he's not eating, you know he's not eating. If he's weak, you help him out. Instead of just lip service. So you need to be an empathetic listener. And if you look at the scale, you see the heart of the empathetic listener. Down to earth. Very low. And look at the knowledge base. The fool says, I know everything, you know, but the wise says, I don't know and I want to learn. So if you know and don't know, then it will help, because then you can get more from people. But if you are not empathetic, you come with some, so you miss out on a lot, and later you become criticized. It pays to listen, as opposed to, because they also criticize, but their criticism is very small as compared to the four we talked about earlier. Then, like I said, the empathetic listener. This be the best level of listening. And
when you finish,
they break out of my thoughts. You know, you have that pain as your thoughts. It's how I see. This is what it is. But when it gets to the level of being empathetic, it's no more your thoughts.
Okay.
You want to consider the others. You want to empty yourself so that you can get 100% of what the person is saying. And that is imperative. They understand others for their point of view and thinks and feels the heart of people. Someone will say that, so which kind of heart are we talking about? Because if you've had a broken heart before, then you know the heart I'm talking about. When they say you have a broken heart, it's not like the organic having their heart in couple, but you know you have a broken heart. So the empathetic listener thinks and feels the heart of the one who is speaking. And so he's able to get a lot. And they are very knowledgeable. They get a lot, but they are down to earth and not complaining and all of that. Sometimes you just have to listen to people. There are various techniques of listening. I want to look at one of them, which is what we call the active listening. One technique that you can use in listening, which is an active listening. And that is acronym I normally use when I'm talking about active of RASA, R-A-S-A, when you're talking about. So let's look at the first one. The first one is to receive. You need to receive what the person is saying. The one communicating with you, you need to receive, which is an R. Receive the information of what the person has got to tell you. And then the next one is to appreciate. If you want to be an active listener, you first receive and appreciate what the person is saying. You do not appreciate it, you will not go further, because you see it as rubbish. So it's important that you appreciate what, you know, the person is trying to say. And then you summarize. After appreciating, you summarize. For instance, I would say that this morning I moved from Ashaman, Lebanon, and then I entered a long container, and the container drove me here, and when I got here, it was so hard. So someone listening to me will ask, you mean he came by a vehicle? He has summarized what I said. That shows that he's actually listening to what I said. So if you came by a vehicle, then which takes us to the fourth one, which is ask. So you ask. And then I know how you were actually listening. So this is one powerful technique you can use, even in the classroom. You need to use this technique. This is a school and you have a lot of students you are teaching. So it's important that you know a lot about listening, and that will help you a great deal. How or what does listening make you? We have people who are immature. Let's look at some of the characteristics of someone with an immature personality. If you do not listen, what do they do? What are the characteristics of those we consider as immature personality? First thing is that they rebound, clear up, shut up. Almost immediately when you say something, they say, oh, that's nonsense. So they rebound, blow up. And if you are the type who's, always fond doing it, and you are showing signs of immature personality, then they believe only in themselves. Immature personality, they believe only in themselves. It's only what they say that is right. What you say is not right to them. And so, because they feel what they are saying is the right way, they will not listen to you. And that is not very good. And they insist on their self-belief. How they see it is what it must be. It's either their way or no way. So if you are that type and show these kinds of characteristics, then we will describe you as an immature personality. And this is not the best. The next one is a mature personality. Of course, if you have an immature, then we look at a mature personality. And what do the mature personality, what do? They accept when it fits their heart. If you say something and it fits their heart, the mature personality will accept it because it fits his or her heart. Then they rebuff. If it does not fit their heart, they rebuff. You may be wondering, okay, what's the difference? The first person will not even listen at all, you will not pay attention, the immature person. But this one will listen, and if he feels it does not fit his or her heart, then it says, oh, that is total nonsense. I don't need it. So if you are mature by allowing the person to talk to you, but then that's just about it. You rebel because it does not fit your heart. Then of course they also understand others, mature personalities. When you get to them, they want to hear you out. They want to know what you've got to tell them. And that is a special gift. Listening is a skill. And it's a very special, general skill you can give to someone. So the mature personality understands others. But this is not the best personality we can get. And that takes us to the best, which is the perfect personality. The perfect personality accepts either it fits their heart or not. Nobody is useless on earth. Even a madman has a value. The madman may be giving you an information that will help you to stay alive for the next moment. Probably he ran from danger somewhere. So even if the madman is speaking, you need to listen. Whether it fits your heart or not, because what have you got to listen from a mad person? You say it's not necessary, but if you are a perfect personality, then your ears will be wide open. And then you take it, whether it fits your heart or not. People don't like madmen. And of course, if I talk about somebody, when the words get into your heart, that will bring a change in your life. Right? Why must we listen? I'm sure some of you have that big question. Why must we listen? And to answer that question, I would ask a question. How many ears do we have? Yes, brother. Yeah, so I just really asked you. Because that's why we're doing something. Okay, give me the answer to that. Yes.
We have two.
Yes. We have two ears, and how many mouths or tongues do we have? One. So, can you tell why you have to listen? Think about it. Nature will give us two ears, but only one tongue. Which is tended means that we should listen more than we talk, but we do the opposite. All the time we are talking, it's like you have scissors in your hand. Before the person is able to say one or two, you cut the person, oh, I already know, I already know. So you have scissors in your hand, that is not very good. You need to listen more than you talk, because God made it so you can listen. Good people listen. And they say that good people, they change when they listen. And wise people, they change by looking at how we went through difficulties. So God in His own wisdom gave us 2 ears. That is why we have to listen more than we talk. Otherwise, we will have problems. I'm sure most of you have heard of Larry King. Anybody's heard of Larry King? Larry King. What do you know about Larry King? Yes, brother. That's right. CNN, yes. Like he says that I never learned anything while I was talking. If he's interviewing people, if he's talking, how can he learn? Because the person has something to tell you. You spend most of the time talking. So what would you learn from the person? There are some people, when you start cutting them like that, then they keep quiet. Even if they have something to tell you, they will not tell you. Because you feel you know. So they take it away. But then, that will not help. So you have to listen, because when you talk more, you learn less. You need to listen more, and then you learn. Right. Then we want to talk about divine listening. Because mind education is about connecting our hearts to God. So giving a mind, that's the difference between a psychologist and a mind specialist. You know, you can have a lot of psychologists, they tell you about so many things, but in the end you don't get any solution. Because they do man must do it. But we try to connect your heart to God. So we want to look at divine listening. Hearts are delivered through the medium of words. So you need to talk it out. There's a lecture we give on isolation, maybe later we'll talk about that. And you see how dangerous it is not to talk if you have a problem. You need to talk. So when you talk it out, then someone can give you pieces of advice, tell you what you have to do, and then console you and all of that. So by the time you keep hearing that, your heart will be delivered through the words that you hear. And of course, you have to accept the heart of God through the word of God. You need to know what clearly the word of God is, and then by accepting the heart of God, then you will be delivered. You will be listening, because your heart will be connected to that of God's heart. And it's very good to listen with the ear, but it's more important to listen with the heart. Can listen with their hearts. Those who cannot talk also listen. The physically challenged also listen. Sometimes you can be with somebody and not say a word, but the person can feel your heart. And the person appreciates that more than your ranting. You know, some people have problems, they just want to talk to somebody. So they want someone to listen to them. Can you be that special person in the life of someone by just offering a listening ear? If you do that, then God will be pleased with you. Call that divine listening. Guess what? You talk more and you lose friends. And you listen and then you gain friends. Don't forget this. You talk more and you lose friends. You listen and then you gain friends. If you are the type who is always talking, you will not get a lot of friends. You need to listen, so they also feel they are important. If you listen to them, you will know they are important, so you will gain friends. People are hurting. People have problems that are not physical. They have mind problems. So they need someone to listen to them. So by you offering the listening ear, you will be solving the great problem in the life of someone. People commit suicide. Just a couple of days ago in my municipal, the driver lost his... the municipal director lost the driver. He committed suicide on himself just 2 days ago. Can you imagine? He just couldn't take it. He had some problems at the workplace. And he couldn't take his home. He committed suicide. Don't say that will not get you. It's what goes around comes around. Because you cannot stop the sun, you have to prepare for it. So that even though it shines, you also have your home. That's why you have to listen. It's very, very important. So I'll end by saying that you should learn to listen. Listen to them. God bless you.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light you see, no, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. Oh, darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Should tumble and fall, or the mountains should crumble to the sea. I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by me. Oh, darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Whenever you're in trouble,